And considering the chairman, his name is Julian Assange, was able to encrypt this, this video from actually military database. So, I'll show you 10 seconds. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First, I will demonstrate how this video is for. When I first stumbled upon this video, I was stupefied how American troops were able to fire Apache firearms into a group of unarmed civilians. And according to the video demonstrated, they easily detailed that what they were holding weren't arms, but they were cameras. As a United States citizen, we must be informed on the way that our military conducts their missions, because if not, we end up with the deaths of civilians. First, I will explain why this video has what this video affects, and secondly, I'm gonna explain how the conversation of the gunmen's within the helicopter had effect, and finally, why this video has been important to the video and the war in Iraq. So first, what effect does this video have? In the incident that was caused by the Apache helicopters, it spurred worldwide controversy whether the helicopters, the men in the helicopters caused or their actions were just. So, New York Times, April 5th, 2010, Reuters had long pressed the release of the video, which consists of 38 numbers of black and white and aerial video between two pilots while they opened fire on people on the street in Baghdad. So according to out of the 12 civilians, there was more than a dozen 12 civilians death and two injuries of two children. And according after the video was uploaded, the Reuters agency whose cameraman was the one who got fired on, they long pressed for a video release and kept insisting in an investigation, but the U.S. never did anything. The pilot's actions are put into question, and later in the article it mentions, but a group of were just a group of million people and mistakes a camera for a weapon. So according after the incident, the general who was acquainted of the mission said that it was a justifying source of a form of carrying out a mission, so it was no problem at all. And as you can see, that they had no firearms, and Amir was just holding a camera and Saeed talking on the phone. And now that we have mentioned what the effort of the video had, let's move right away to the conversation that the Apache gunman had during the fight. Assange strongly states that his opinion in the conversation that the gunman had affects the way that our military conveys their missions. According to Assange, I believe that if the killings were under the rules of engagement, then the rules of engagement are really wrong. Deeply wrong, as the flyers acting like they were paying a video game. So during the length of the video, you hear the pilots saying, "Oh, come on, let us shoot. Oh, you're dead bastards." They mentioned like they were playing games. So like, they're getting the clear to be able to shoot at the unarmed civilians. They're happily like saying, "Oh, let's kill these bastards. Oh, got them, light them up." So as the example that I gave in, Assange says that the rules of engagement shouldn't be this way, so this is how the video affects the way we portray our military. And so we have just mentioned how the conversation of the soldiers showed controversy. And for the last point, I'm going to mention why this information is irrelevant to the war in Iraq. During the war in Iraq, it was estimated that from 2003 to 2007 that 114,000 civilians were killed by coalition forces. And by IraqiBodyCount.org, December 30, 2011, U.S. forces killed more Iraqi civilians than any other force, claiming the life of 15,135 civilian lives. So as you see here in the blue, to the beginning of the war, the U.S. caused more deaths than any other, except the Iraqi forces. Deaths of civilians. So this is if you put in the video in question in mind, and the deaths of civilians, we put in question how our military is putting the lives of people at stake and how they conduct their missions. As is shown in the video, it was pretty careless. Also in IraqiBodyCount.org, it also mentions the frequency of small-scale killings in the U.S. And from 2000 to 2007, it's estimated that the U.S. military force killed over 3 civilians a day, making it 3.3 a day, and when they killed 2,617 deaths over the decade. So this is a picture of a cartoon politics on the war in Iraq. So it says, so how's the war on terrorism going? Okay, I guess. So as a public, we should be informed how the wars that we are involved in are going on. For example, the video. There has been countless articles debating whether our army did our military deal was just. And so first, I discussed how the video had any effect at all. Second, I discussed why the gunman's video, a gunman's conversation had any controversy. And thirdly, I discussed why the video had any effect on the war in Iraq.
Y'all really quick.